just have had, we've had three Sunday nights on DVD, and I'd like to hear one in person. Alex Martinez.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Hallelujah. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go. Amen. To the house of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. We are having revival. Amen. Are you ready for the harvest? Amen. This is the year to equip the saints for the work of the ministry. Amen. I was looking at Brother Ron, and he brought a whole crew on Wednesday. We baptized some. God is doing some things. Amen. Hallelujah. And tomorrow we have our altars workers training, and it's going to be awesome. It's going to be hands-on, very different than the other training that we had. And so we encourage you to come at 7 p.m. here, okay? 7 p.m. We might go an hour and a half, all right? It's going to be hands-on, and it's going to be an ongoing process. Amen?
Amen.
We're going to get more effective saving souls. Amen?
Amen?
Hallelujah. It's an honor to speak to you tonight. I don't take it lightly, and I feel the Lord has given me something. Amen? To talk to me first, and then to the whole body. Amen?
Amen.
Thank you, Pastor, for trusting and taking the risk. Amen. What a word we heard this morning.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I told him he is outgrowing his own skin.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Let's go to 1 Chronicles chapter 28, verse 9. Amen. 1 Chronicles 28, verse 9. Amen. Hallelujah. This is David talking to his son.
Yeah.
It says, "And thou, Solomon, my son, know thou the God of thy father, and serve him with a perfect heart and with a willing mind. For the Lord searcheth all hearts, and understandeth all the imaginations of the thoughts. If thou seek him, he will be found of thee. But if thou forsake him, he will cast thee off forever." Hallelujah. That just takes aside that one save over save doctrine.
Amen.
Amen. And then he says, "Take heed now." Everybody say, "Take heed."
Take heed.
"Now, for the Lord hath chosen thee to build a house for the sanctuary. Be strong and do it." Then David gave Solomon his son the pattern of the porch and of the houses thereof and the treasures thereof and of the upper chambers thereof and of the inner parlors thereof and of the place of the mercy seat and the pattern of all that he had by the spirit of the course of the house of the Lord and all the chambers round about of the treasuries of the house of God and the treasuries of the dedicated things also for the courses of the priests and the Levites and for all the work of the service of the house of the Lord, and for all the vessels of service in the house of the Lord." And everybody say, "That's me."
That's me.
Amen. Now let's go to 1 Timothy. Amen. Old Testament, then New Testament. 1 Timothy. Amen. Chapter 4, verse 12. This is Paul talking to Timothy. "Let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity. Till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. Neglect not the gift that is in thee, which was given thee by prophecy with the laying on of the hands of the presbytery. Meditate upon these things, give thyself wholly unto them, that thy profiting may appear to all." And then he says, "Take heed." Everybody say, "Take heed."
Take heed.
"Unto thyself and unto the doctrine. Continue in them, for in doing this thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee."
Amen.
Amen. I want to talk to you today about a father's plea. A father's plea.
All right. All right.
Let's lift up our hands unto the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, We bind every lying voice and every lying spirit. We bind every false doctrine, Father. We loose revelation, O Lord, right now, in the name of Jesus. We ask that you grant unto me boldness in the Holy Ghost. And let signs and wonders be done in your name. And everybody say, in Jesus' name. Jesus. Come on, clap your hands unto the Lord. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Amen, amen, amen. Gonna make a disclaimer out here. Amen. I'm gonna murder the King's English. Amen. It's guaranteed I will do it. It's gonna be some Spanglish. Amen.
Come on.
But I'm gonna also try to murder every lying voice and every lying spirit from the enemy. Hallelujah. In the scriptures we just read, we can see and understand the heart of two fathers. One of them is the King David, talking to his own son Solomon, whom God has chosen to build a house, a temple, a sanctuary for his name.
Right.
Amen. The other father is the Apostle Paul, talking to his son in Christ. His son in the gospel,
right,
whom God has chosen to build the New Testament church.
You're right.
Amen. Hallelujah. I thank God that I have a son that is my blood. Amen. But I thank God that God can also use us to have sons in the gospels. And sons and daughters in the gospel.
Amen.
And although David and Paul were years apart, they both wanted their sons to succeed by building a temple for the Lord our God.
Amen. Come on.
Solomon was fixing to take the baton and build what his father couldn't build.
Okay.
Hallelujah. And although nothing compared to Solomon's temple, according to the scriptures and according to history, that temple was only a shadow of the temple that God was fixing to build in the New Testament.
Amen.
The temple is us.
Right. Yeah. Come on. Amen.
Since God never was pleased to just dwell inside four walls, his desire was to dwell in the human heart.
Amen.
These two fathers were very different. And they were years and centuries apart.
Right.
However, they both had a huge burden in their hearts. And they both had communicated to their sons the same plea. Right. And that plea was, take heed.
Right.
Take heed. David said, take heed now. For the Lord has chosen thee to build a sanctuary. Be strong and do it.
All right.
Hallelujah. To take heed means to listen to and to follow through.
Amen.
To place close attention.
All right.
Hallelujah. To place a great focus. To put your mind and put your soul into it. To regard with care, to take notice of, to watch for danger, to place a high degree of seriousness. He said, take heed, be careful, watch out, for this is the greatest thing you can ever do. And you better watch out. You better pay attention. You better regard it as something sacred.
Amen. Come on, Wendy.
Why did David give this plea to his son? Because he was fixing to build a house where the King of Glory would dwell.
Right.
Where the King of Glory will speak. Right. Where the King of Glory will manifest, will heal.
Come on, Wendy.
Hallelujah. He was fixing to build a temple his ear. If there was a prayer done in that temple, his ear will hear it, and his eye will be attentive.
Right, come on.
To that prayer.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Exactly right.
But centuries later, Paul gives Timothy the same plea. And he tells him, take heed unto thyself.
Yep.
Hallelujah. I love it because you, yourself, are the temple of God.
Right. Amen.
This is where God's spirit dwells, and this is where God's name dwells.
Yep.
Hallelujah. It is in us that God's name and spirit will dwell forever. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Paul pleaded with Timothy saying, take heed. Watch out, son. Don't mess around with this.
Right, right, right.
Don't play around with this. Take heed. Be careful. Watch out.
Right. Amen.
Take heed because in the latter days some shall depart from the faith.
Right.
Giving heed to seducing spirits.
Right.
And doctrines of devils. Hallelujah. Take heed because there's people, they will have a conscience that will be seared with a hot iron.
Right.
Right.
They won't care that they're not following God. They won't care that they don't seek after God.
Right.
Their conscience is dead. So he said, take heed. Because men shall be lovers of their own selves.
Right.
They're going to be covetous. They're going to be boasters. They're going to be proud. They're going to be blasphemers. They're going to be disobedient to parents. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
That's right.
They're going to be unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good.
That's right.
And if that was 2,000 years ago, imagine it now what Paul would say to a son in Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Take heed, Timothy. Watch out, my son, because they will be high-minded. Lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God.
Amen.
Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof. From such, turn away. Hallelujah. He was saying, take heed, Timothy. Watch out. Because these knuckleheads are always learning and never are able to come to the knowledge of the truth. These people resist the truth. Men of corrupt minds, reprobate concerning the faith. Therefore, my son, take heed unto thyself.
Come on.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And if there was a cry that right now I feel the Lord is telling us, amen, is to take heed.
Yeah. Right.
Because there's going to be many seducing spirits
right.
in these last days. There's going to be wars and rumors of war. There's going to be a lot of things that are going to bring persecution to the Christian church. Hallelujah. I'm talking about serious stuff that he wrote to his son. But he didn't stop there. He goes on and tells him also, take heed to yourself, but also to the doctrine.
Come on now.
Hallelujah. I'm talking about the doctrine. What you teach. You got to be careful of what you preach, my son. Because if you don't know what you're preaching or you mess around with the doctrine, you're going to mess around with your soul and the souls of all that are listening to you. But if you continue in the doctrine, you're going to sell yourself and then that he. Hallelujah. He said, continue in them, for in doing this, thou shalt both save thyself.
And then that hear thee.
He said, watch out what doctrine you teach, son.
Right.
Right.
He said, be careful, my son, of what doctrine you teach, for the doctrine will save you.
Yes, it will.
Hallelujah. Some people say doctrine won't save you. The doctrine will save you. Hallelujah. Jesus' name baptism will save you. Receiving the baptism of the Holy Ghost will save you. Repentance from that word will save you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm talking about a war.
Amen.
I'm talking about the serious commandment and the most serious plea a father will give to his son. In Ephesians 2:19, he declared, "Now therefore ye are no more strangers or foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God, and ye are built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone."
Right. Amen.
I'm going to say it like this. There is no other saving doctrine than the apostles' doctrine. Talking about the apostles' doctrine.
Right.
In Acts 2:42 states that the ones that were baptized, they continued steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine.
Right.
Hallelujah. Paul was saying, "Be careful, my son, that you depart from the apostolic doctrine."
Right.
Be careful. And in 2017, we have to be careful that we leave the apostolic doctrine, because in the last days, there will be every wind of doctrine, according to the Bible. Floating around the prince of the power of the air is going to be floating with a variety of different doctrines. But if there or denominations, and I don't know if we can call them churches. They may be much better in many things than us, but I'm not living the apostolic doctrine. They may have a better choir, they may have better programs, they may have a better Sunday school program, they may have a better outreach program, they may have a lot of better things, but if they don't got the apostolic, the prayers of Jesus are covering the apostles' doctrine. I'll prove it to you. John 17:20. Neither pray I for these alone, talking about the apostles, but for them also which shall believe on me through their words. I'm talking about Jesus has prayed for us. Jesus has prayed. The prayers of the King of kingdom.
Right.
And in Luke 24:45, Jesus appeared unto the disciples, and then he opened their understanding.
Right.
Could you put Acts, Luke 24 right there. Hallelujah. 24, 24:45. And their understanding was open, and this is what he said: thus it is written, and thus behold Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead the third day. Right. That's the apostles' doctrine. Death, burial, resurrection.
Amen. Amen. All
right. Hallelujah. And here we go. And then, don't tell me God called you to preach it. You don't preach what he told you to preach.
Amen.
Are you going to preach repentance? Well, I don't know. I might offend some people. You know, they might leave the church. So, their blood is going to be in your hands if you don't preach repentance. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then he said, and the remissions of sins shall be preached in his name. And what is his name?
That's right.
What is his name? The wind of me, amen. So many kisses. Hallelujah. I'm talking about churches that don't preach repentance. Amen. They don't preach that you have to turn from your wicked ways.
Right.
I don't want a preacher that tell me I'm doing okay and then I end up in hell. People that I talked to, and they said, well, that was only for the Jews. No, read the Word of God. It says to preach it among all nations.
Right.
Puerto Ricans, Jamaicans, Cubans, hallelujah, Russians, all nations. But you're going to start at Jerusalem.
Right. Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm talking about every wind of doctrine is out there. Do you believe in the doctrine?
Yeah.
Are you really standing in the foundations of the apostle?
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
Jesus Christ died, was buried, and resurrected. And we need to die in repentance.
Right.
Be buried in baptism for the remissions of our sins in the name of Jesus Christ.
Right.
This may seem a little elementary to you, amen? But there's a battle. Hallelujah. And you need to be grounded in the faith.
Right.
We must receive God's nature. when we receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Amen. You're right.
That's the resurrection.
Yeah.
That's the new life. That's that dunamis. That's that power after you receive the Holy Ghost.
Yeah. Yeah, man.
And how do you know? Do you know because you start dancing?
Nope.
Do you know because you're slain in the Spirit? Or do you know because the Word of God says that when the Spirit falls, there's going to be a sound?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Watch out. Take heed. Because our Lord commanded this to be preached.
Right. Amen.
Jesus said, I came not to call the righteous but sinners to repentance.
Right. Amen. Amen.
Well, I don't want to preach on repentance. I want to preach on prosperity. I want to preach on making people feel good. Being uplifted. I'm telling you, when I was trying to learn golf, the instructor told me he's going to look worse before he looks better. Because you got to get all of your old habits. And then if you do what I tell you, then you're going to start hitting the ball straight.
Come on.
And the same thing with God. In order to go up, your knees must go down. You need to humble yourself.
Amen.
Under the mighty hand of God. Hallelujah. Jesus began to preach, saying, this is how he began to preach according to the Bible. He said, repent. For the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
Right.
He said, except you repent, you shall all likewise perish.
Right.
Then we got you this little knuckleheads that all of a sudden they think they know it all. Well, I don't need to preach that. You know, that's condemning. That's condemning. That's not condemning. That's convicting.
Right. Amen.
Hallelujah. You see, you got to be careful who you listen to.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm telling you, I'm careful. I don't listen to all these televangelists and all these radio evangelists and all these knuckleheads.
Right.
And I pray that the Lord will give them the revelation. Amen.
Amen.
But I'm very careful of listening to them.
That's right.
Hallelujah. As a matter of fact, I'm very careful of listening to some in UPC too. Church and all this funny baloney, I'm here to tell you, you better stand on the Word of God. You better stand on the foundation of the apostles.
Amen.
In 2 Peter 3:9, Peter said that God is not willing that any should perish, but that all, say all, come to repentance.
Right.
Hallelujah. That's the doctrine. How you gonna preach it? God wants us to turn from our wicked ways and turn towards Him.
Right. Amen.
That's repentance. Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
That's right.
The Apostles' Doctrine states that remissions of sin can only be found in Jesus' name.
Right.
Can I get an amen?
Right. Amen.
Hallelujah. Peter told and he opened his mouth and began preaching at Cornelius' house in Acts 10. And he said in Acts 10:43, to him, Jesus, give all the prophets witness that through his name, whosoever believeth in him shall receive remissions of sins. Through his name, all the prophets. That means that from the Old Testament to the New Testament, everything is pointing at one person, one name.
Right. Amen.
One sacrifice. One spirit.
Right.
And that is Jesus.
Amen.
Woo. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is why I'm not leaving the apostolic doctrine.
Right. Right. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If there's something better, we need to go out there, but there's nothing better.
Right. Amen.
And where much is given, much is required.
Right.
The Lord has given us more than anybody else.
Yes, He has. Yes, He has.
Ooh, what a responsibility.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Take heed. Be careful.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Because when you let go of the name, you are letting go of the doctrine. Hallelujah. I was talking to this young man. Hallelujah. He was talking to me, and he used to work with me, and said, what are you telling me? That the people in my church are not saved because they don't baptize in Jesus' name like you guys do? Come on now, that's a strong question, huh?
Yeah.
And this is how I answer that question. Neither is there salvation in any other. For there's no other name given under heaven, given among men, whereby we must be saved. Woo!
Hallelujah!
Woo!
Hallelujah! His Father a name, his Son a name, his Holy Spirit a name.
Come on.
Jesus said, I came in my Father's name. The name of Jesus means Jehovah salvation. So that means that the name of Jesus is the saving name of Jehovah. That's why the angel said, and thou shalt call his name
Jesus.
And thou shalt call his name
Jesus.
For he will save his people from their sins. There's no way around it. Only Jesus can save us. What about the Comforter? What about the Holy Ghost? Come on now. Well, read the word, because he said, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will say in my name. See, everything is through the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. If the Bible was a cell phone, the name of Jesus would be the image that you will touch, and it will be the icon that you can go and get into the Word of God.
Hallelujah.
He is the door. He is the way. He is the lamb. He is the sacrifice. He is the mercy seat. He is the bread. He is the incense. He is the Father. Take heed. Because Satan is on a mission to hinder people from receiving the revelation of the name of Jesus.
Right. Amen.
Now think about it, if you were Satan, come on now, and you knew that people can believe and receive this revelation and then use the name of Jesus to heal the ones that you have oppressed, and use the name of Jesus to cast out demons, wouldn't you do all that is in your power to hinder people from receiving this revelation? Hallelujah. Come on, wouldn't you do it?
Amen.
Come on now. Wouldn't you, if you have your little kingdom, huh? And you knew that the name of Jesus, whew, is dangerous. You will do anything in your power. Hallelujah. And he's a crafty guy.
Amen.
He's going to go and try to do anything that he can to hinder people from coming to this revelation. Hallelujah. But you got to be like the apostles. They didn't care.
Right.
They rejoiced when they were persecuted for the name of Jesus Christ.
Right. Come on.
Come on.
They were.
Hallelujah. I know that the conservative party is right now in power, but I'm here to tell you, it's not going to last long. There's going to be a new Pharaoh in Egypt soon.
Come on.
And we're going to be persecuted. And you better be grounded, because if you're not grounded, your kids won't be grounded.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And we go to Acts 4. What's this? Acts 4, 16. What's this? They heal a man, and this is what they get for healing a man.
Say, what shall we do to these men? For that indeed a notable miracle has been done by them is manifest to all that are Jerusalem, and we cannot deny it.
Cannot deny it. That's what happens when you preach the name. Miracles are going to happen.
You're right.
Hallelujah. Healings are going to happen. Because there's power in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
something. I'm here to tell you. I'm not preaching against Trinitarians. I'm preaching against the doctrine of the Trinity.
Amen.
I believe Satan came up with that.
Yeah.
Why? So now people can say, Holy Mary, Mother of God. Come on now.
Come on.
So that people, when they pray in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. So that people won't get baptized in the name of Jesus.
Right.
Hallelujah. I'm talking about truth. The apostles' doctrine.
Right.
Do you believe it? You better take care. You better take heed.
Amen.
I better take care. And I better take heed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
I'm here to tell you, Jesus, God didn't have a mother. We serve a high priest after the order of Melchizedek. He didn't have a father. He didn't have a mother. Hallelujah. One lady said, well, you know, it's like when, you know, when you can't ask your dad, you come to your mom and you ask her and she intercedes, you know, and she'll give you the $20. Hallelujah. But the Bible, the Word of God says that there's only one mediator between God and man, and that is the man Christ Jesus.
Right. Amen.
Hallelujah. Go ahead, Pastor. Hallelujah.
All right. But that it spread no further among the people, let us greatly threaten them that they speak henceforth no to no man in this name.
All right. So, you know, they didn't go, hey, Brother Peter and Brother John, would you please stop preaching in the name of Jesus? They didn't go like that.
Right.
Come on. They straightly commanded them.
That's right.
I'm sorry, okay? Well, they grabbed and threatened them. And they got on their face and says, don't teach in this name.
That's right.
They locked them up and they beat them up.
Right. Right.
Hallelujah. But what did the apostles do? Watch this.
Praise God.
And they called them and commanded them not to speak or teach in the name of Jesus.
Uh-huh.
But Peter and John answered and said unto them, whether it's right in the sight of God to hearken unto you more than unto God, judge ye.
But we
cannot but speak the things which we have seen and heard.
Amen.
We cannot stop talking about it. God has healed us. You see, if you want to bear fruit, you got to be pruned.
Right.
Hallelujah. And if God leaves you alone and doesn't prune you, that means you're not producing.
Yes, yes.
You're not being effective.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Watch. This is chapter 4 and chapter 5, verse 28. It happens again. They do another mighty work, and then they counsel come the religious people of the day.
Right.
They come in again. They come in. Hey, look over here, Brother John and Brother Peter again, huh? Go ahead, Pastor. What's this?
Okay, I'm going one verse you didn't ask for. And when they had brought them, they set it before the council, and the high priest asked them.
Sit down, boy, sit down. Huh?
Saying, did we not straightly command you that you should not teach in this name?
I'm sorry. Don't want to be disrespectful. Didn't we straightly command you not to teach in this name?
Go ahead. And behold, you filled Jerusalem with your doctrine and intend to bring this man's blood upon us.
See, that's what happens when you preach the name. Yeah, the blood.
Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than men.
Come on now, you're going to say it like you mean it, all right? You're Peter, all right? No, blood. Come on, like you mean it. We rather obey God.
I'm not an actor.
He said, we'd rather obey God.
Amen.
Come on now. Amen. Why? Amen. Because God called us, came on the gospel, the King of the kingdom. Hallelujah. Oh, I'm sorry. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah. That's I'm talking good. About some whoopsies nowadays that are in the first problem, they give up. Well, if you're not telling them again, their blood is going to be in your head. Hallelujah. I'm talking about, do they really need to be baptized in Jesus' name? Yes. Yes. There's no way around.
That's right.
In Acts 9, Paul, the Lord calls him, and he put us in his heart to go to Jerusalem and preach. And he's fixing to go, and all of a sudden this certain prophet comes around and says, and gets Paul's girdle and wraps him up in his hand and feet, and he says, thus says the Holy Ghost. This is how they are going to do to you if you go to Jerusalem.
That's right.
Hallelujah. I'm talking about you're going to be in some danger if you preach the name of Jesus.
Right.
You're going to be in some danger if you believe, really believe the word of God. Hallelujah. They're going to call you intolerant. They are not intolerant.
Come on.
All right.
Come on.
They're going to call you legalistic.
Right.
They're going to call you a whole bunch of things, but guess what? You are pleasing God.
Right.
Preach. If you continue.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And this is, they go ahead and this guy comes in and, oh my God, this guy's apostle. The apostle Shakalaka and the prophet Chuchilati. And the deacon and missionary and all his titles, and he's prophesying the wrong thing.
That's right.
Come on.
Because Paul said, I'll cut this junk out.
Come on.
Cut this crying out.
Come on.
I'm ready not only to be bound, but to die and suffer for the name of Jesus.
Amen.
None of these things move me.
Hallelujah. Come on now.
Woo.
I'm talking about some war!
Right.
Hallelujah. Come on. They all started weeping. Hallelujah. And Paul said, you know what? I'm ready to die.
That's right.
Hallelujah. For the name of Jesus.
Right.
In Acts 9, the Lord told Ananias, don't be afraid of Paul, because I'm going to reveal to him how he's going to suffer for my name's sake.
Right.
And now, all of a sudden, 2,000 years later, we got all these ministers that say, we don't want to say Jesus. We don't want to say, we don't want to pray in Jesus' name. We don't want to put the name Jesus on our American dollar. We just put God. Very general. Very general. Amen? Hallelujah. But imagine if you put the name Jesus. In Jesus we trust.
Come on. Come on.
Hallelujah. I'm not an American. Amen?
Come on.
And believe it or not, now I'm not a Puerto Rican either.
Come on.
I'm a citizen of the kingdom of God. My home is the New Jerusalem.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I'm talking about, man, don't not baptizing in Jesus' name raise flags to you that you're going the wrong way. Well, they're sincere. Was Cornelius sincere?
Yes.
Did Cornelius love God?
Yes.
Did Cornelius have faith in God?
Right.
Did he have angels visit him?
Yes.
Right.
Did he have a memorial of prayers in heaven?
Yes.
Was he saved?
No.
Was he born again?
Oh, yeah.
But the moment Peter preached, preached to Cornelius.
Come on.
The whole house got baptized with the Holy Ghost.
Woo! Hallelujah.
And how did they know the Holy Ghost fell on them?
Heard him speak with tongue.
Verse 46, for they heard him speak with tongue and magnify God.
Amen.
That is the biblical way you get the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And in verse 48, Peter commanded them to be baptized in the name of the Lord.
That's right. In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Come on.
I got the Holy Ghost in 99. I've been in this probably 18, 17 years. Amen. Listen to what I'm saying. You guys, some of you have been here before me. Amen. Some of you helped me grow. Some of you were big brothers and big sisters that helped us. Amen. And here's one thing. We might not have all things right, but we preach the same saving message that the apostles preached when the church of the New Testament was founded.
Right.
Amen.
This is why I'm not living this church.
Come on.
I want you.
I'm not living UPC.
Come on.
Not because they're perfect, but because they preach the apostles' doctrine.
Hey.
I don't want to, you know, I want to be,
find the word.
I don't know. Confrontational, let's put it that way, amen? Controversial. But here we go. 98% of the folks that have left the UPC and the Apostolic Doctrine, they all became more carnal.
Right. Absolutely.
They never become more spiritual.
Right.
To my estimation. And I'm talking about preachers, even preachers that leave.
Right. That's true.
You know many of them. Hallelujah. I'm glad our pastor has stood still. Focusing on the outward. Well, you guys focus on the outward. And maybe, yes, sometimes I'm telling you, there's some dumb people. Amen?
Right.
There's some dumb people that, you know, there's dumb people everywhere you go. Amen? Hallelujah. You go to work, there's some dumb people at work.
Come on.
You don't stop working.
You look at your family and my family, there's some dumb people in our family. And they are going to be dumb people in the church also.
Come on. Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm sorry. We need to preach this in love. Faith that worketh by love. But I'm here to tell you, you better stand on what you know is the truth.
Amen.
They argue, well, that the hour, you focus more on the hour. Well, let me tell you something. 2 Corinthians 6:16 says, God said, and what agreement hath the temple of God with idols? For ye are the temple of the living God. As God has said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people.
Amen.
Wherefore, come out separate, saith the Lord,
right.
And touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you.
Right.
Well, it doesn't matter. It matters.
Yes, it does.
Read the book of Revelation. The bride was clothed in linen. What was the linen? Their good works. And then he says, and I will be a father unto you, and ye shall be my sons. And my daughter saith the Lord God Almighty.
Right.
What is their father saying? Take heed.
All right.
Be careful.
That's it. Watch out.
You're better than this. Come clean, and I will receive you.
Right.
That's it. Paul said it in 1 Corinthians 10 and 12. Let him that thinketh he standeth take heed lest he fall. Hallelujah. I'm talking about being grounded in the faith, in the apostolic faith. Hallelujah. Are you grounded? Come on. Are you letting go of some things? You better watch out, because we open the door, the hedge that God has put around us. If we let go of this, and if we let go of that.
Right. Right.
Hallelujah. I was thinking about that sermon about the filter, what's in your filter. And I'm here to tell you, you know, at first I was like, man, that was only for preachers. No. That was not only for preachers. That was for everybody.
Right.
Come on. We as parents may have things in our filters. And doubts, and maybe we don't have a full conviction of things, and we start spreading those things and letting those things drip onto our children. And I'm here to tell you, Satan is not taking a day off. He's not going to the Bahamas. He's going to work because he knows his time is short.
Right.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I heard. That J.A. Mangan, because of the Times meeting, when they had all the preachers said, he got up and said, let me tell you something, brother. Hallelujah. I'm going to reach out as far as I can. But I will never leave this truth. I'm going to try to get you as much as I can, but I will not leave this truth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Recently, we had Brother Demersian pass. Amen.
Right.
Yeah. I talked to Brother Hattaball this morning. I said, hey, what did he say? What did he say in his last words? What were they? And he said, this is what he said. He said it to you only or to some ministers? No, he said it to his sons, his ministers, that he taught Bible studies to, that he brought them up. And he said, make disciples.
Come on.
Open Bible schools. Teach the word. Keep the doctrine. Stay in truth.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Case closed.
Thank you, Jesus.
Would you stand right now? Come on. Hallelujah. We're in a war. We're in a war. Our children are depending on.
Yes, sir.
Right.
I look at my grandson, and the greatest thing I can give him is a man of God.
That's right.
Amen.
He will see that there is a God that loves him.
Right.
I'm talking about my daughter and PK. They did some counseling session to all the students about suicide. And how you gotta watch out, because young people are committing suicide all over the place. Because the father of lies is lying to them. You're too ugly. You're too fat. You're this and you're that. And so she shared with my wife, and my wife, well, what do you think, Genesis? What do you have to say about that? And you know what she said? She said, I have a purpose.
Come on. Come on.
I have a purpose.
That's awesome.
Come on, we all have a purpose.
Right.
Come on. Take heed. Be careful. Don't let doubt drip. Don't bring confusion.
Right.
Come on, let's hang on. Let's hang on to that truth.
Right.
Let's hang on to that apostolic doctrine.
Right.
For in doing it, you're going to save yourself. And everyone that hears.
Right.
Ooh, hallelujah.
Come on, lift up your hands right now to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Come on, right now, Father, in the name of Jesus. That's it. Repentance is in the house. Come on. Forgive us. We all have done it, oh Lord. We all have. said it. We all had allowed doubt to drip, oh Lord. We all had allowed bitterness or a problem in our lives or a situation. Hallelujah. Would you come to the altar right now? Come on, let's pray. Let's make a consecration unto the Lord. We all, Father, need you, Lord.